Hello friends, hope you are doing good. Let's continue our chapter number 2, theory based accounting. My name is CA Rahul Bajaj and we will start with the basic concept. Here is generally accepted accounting principles. It is also called as GAAP, GAAP. Okay, what is meaning of GAAP? Yesterday I got feedback from one of the students that Hindi English language, both language to be mixed up. So I'm trying to explain in Hindi as well. Okay, what is meaning of GAAP? GAAP is in order to maintain uniformity and consistency in accounting records, certain rules, principles have been developed and which are accepted by the accounting profession in respect in India or in respective countries. Okay. For India is Indian GAAP, for US, US GAAP. Okay, so now we are moving to the next level, worldwide GAAP. Okay, so that is concept which is called as IFRS, International Financial Reporting System. Now currently what is happening, India is having some separate GAAP, US is having some separate GAAP, European countries having their own GAAP. So there is still inconsistency as due to increase in technology. See, there is collaboration, like the entire world becomes very small now. So now one person has to invest in US or Singapore or in Europe somewhere, but he is not able to compare the financials. So to maintain uniformity and consistency, that everyone is preparing on the same principle, concept, conventions, assumptions, principles, etc. So this is called as a GAAP. So now right now we have Indian GAAP. So India is also moving towards IFRS, that is International Financial Reporting Standard. So there are certain carve outs. Okay, except those point, we are in similar line with worldwide accounting policies, worldwide accounting accepted accounting principles. Okay, IFRS. Some carve outs which are necessary, like the based on our geographical nature, based on our tax system, based on Indian culture, or based on the specific requirement of country, those are carved out. Okay, means those are not in line with IFRS, except that everything is in line with IFRS. In India, we are moving from accounting standard to Ind AS. Okay, we will discuss that in latter part of our lecture once we move to the next part. So we have understood here the meaning of GAAP. GAAP is just to maintain uniformity and consistency in accounting records. There are certain principles, concepts, assumptions, conventions, those are followed. Okay, which are followed by accounting profession all over the India. So let's move to the basic concepts of accounting. I will just name out the main basic concepts of accounting is business entity, money measurement, going concern, accounting period, cost, well accept aspect, revenue recognition, matching concept, full disclosure, consistency, prudence, materiality and objectivity. So business entity concept. What do you mean by business entity concept? Business entity concept, assume that business is distinct from its owner. So entity, say business entity concept, what it says, while preparing the books of account, we assume that business is different and owner is different, be it in proprietorship, partnership account, company's account, anything. So this is very basic assumption. So this assumptions gives us this will help us to understand that why we show our capital invested. See, anybody invest capital in business, why that is shown in liability? Because of business entity concept. What it says, business owing money to that particular proprietor, shareholders, partners. Okay, so that this is very basic assumption which defines business has a distinct and a separate identity from its owner. Very easy. Okay. So let's move to the next concept, money measurement concept. So accounting is language. Okay. Only transaction in monetary terms can be recorded in accounting. Things which are not of monetary terms, those things which cannot be expressed in money, is cannot be recorded in books of account. Very simple. Only things, transactions and happenings which are in terms of money are to be recorded in books of account. Things which are not, which cannot be measurable in money, cannot be recorded in books of account. Let's move to the next concept, going concern concept. So going concern, what it says, that business will continue for indefinite period. That is going concern concept. Okay, so this assumption says the business will continue for longer period. Say it will continue for more than 12 months. See, in simple language, for basic understanding. Say we purchase fixed asset. Why do we depreciate only relevant portion of current year or a relevant portion for the period in the books of account, and we maintain assets like that will be used subsequently? Because we assume that business will continue for infinite period. So the basic assumption that books will continue on going concern concept. Accounting period concept. What is accounting period concept? Accounting period concept is that refers to a span of time at the end of which financial statement of an enterprise are prepared. So normally 12 months everyone knows. Here one thing we have to notice, we have to understand that there is a difference between financial year and calendar year. Calendar year starts in the month of January, ends in the month of December. Financial year start in the month of April, ends in the month of March. So currently we are in the financial year 2020-21. That is the financial year starting at 1st April 2020 and ending in at 31st March 2021. In certain cases, the interim financial statement, like we have discussed, 12 months, the financial statements are prepared only after period, say normally for a period of 1 year. But there are certain cases, say for income tax, the financial statements are prepared annually. Okay, but in case of, in certain cases, there are also interim financial statement. Those are required as per Companies Act, SEBI's regulation. Even in case of partnership and partnership, if there is a retirement of partners or a joining of partner, the interim financial statement can be prepared. So these are the example accounting period concept. For generally, normally the accounting period is 1 year. Next, we will move to cost concept. What cost concept says? All assets are to be recorded at purchase price. Okay, all assets to be recorded at purchase price. That is what my cost concept says. So for example, if I am buying a plant and machinery for 10,000 rupees and I am incurring 2,000 rupees installation expenses, so my asset to be recorded at 10,000 or 12,000. It should be recorded at 12,000 because asset will be capitalized when it is ready to use. Very important concept. Everyone should remember this. Asset to be capitalized when it is ready to use. So all the efforts made, all labor charges, transport charges, installation charges, anything paid to make asset ready to use is my cost of that asset. Cost concept says all the assets are to be recorded at my book, at my purchase price. So now you will see there is a limitation in cost concepts. say 10 years before, 10 years ago, I have purchased a land worth rupees 1 lakh. Now my book shows it as a 1 lakh till today. Okay, because asset to be recorded at purchase price. But the actual valuation of that land is now 50 lakhs. Correct? So the cost concept has a limitation that it does not take care of inflation. Please remember the limitation of cost concept is the historical cost basis that does not show the true worth of business and may lead hidden profits. Correct? So now, right now, just I have given example. Say I have purchased a land worth rupees 1 lakh 10 years before. Now its valuation is say 50 lakh rupees. So there is hidden profit of 49 lakhs. But that is not being considered in my books of account because of cost concept. So this is certain points, this limitation one has to remember. Now we will move to the next concept, that is dual aspect concept. What dual aspect concept says, every transaction has a dual fold effect or two fold effect. Okay, in definition also, in a like introduction to accounting, we have seen that every debit, the Likasa Pacioli's book that has referred that every debit should have one credit. Okay, so now currently we operate in double entry accounting system. So every debit has a credit effect, every credit has a debit effect. So all the transaction must have two fold effect. For example, see, Mr. Ram has started a business by investing rupees 50 lakhs. So now my cash account will have 50 lakhs impact and capital account will have 50 lakhs impact. Correct? Dual impact. Two fold effect. One is in cash account, another is in capital account. Similarly, while we will move to the practical problems, we will try to understand how it works. Now, to give you a clarity, if any one of you have seen that T-shaped balance sheet, T-format balance sheet, then you will see that capital plus liabilities equal to my assets, because capital will come on, capital and liabilities will come on my left side, assets will come on my right side. If still there is some confusion, we'll see that in next chapter where we will start with practical problems. So next concept is revenue recognition concept. So revenue recognition concept, what it says, business revenue for business transaction should be included in the accounting records only when it is realized. Only when it is realized. Just understand this term, only when it is realized. So does that mean we will follow only cash system, not accrual system? No. When we will call it realized, when there is a legal right to receive is arise. Okay, so if I have sold and sold goods to Mr. X, okay, I have given him invoice, all legal points have been taken care. Now my right has been established. I have sold, I have delivered, goods are with him. So he is now liable to pay legally. So my legal right has been established. So I will record it in my books of account. Very simple. See, definition says revenue for the business transaction should be recorded in accounting records only when it is realized. But definition of realize, what it says, the realization should be considered when legal right to receive has been created. If you have right to receive for particular money on account which is realizable or receivable on account of your sales, if you have legal right, then you will treat it as a realized and you will incorporate that sales in your books of account. So let's start with another concept, which is matching concept. Matching concept, what it says, expenses incurred in an accounting period should be matched with revenue during the period. Okay, have anybody understood? Okay, I will explain you. Say, if I am making sales, so related expenses has to be booked in the same period. If I am booking, say for last 10 years, I am doing a construction project, I am incurring all the expenses, etc., etc. So I am booking expenses in last 10 years and booking sales in this year. No, all those construction will go in my inventory, and I will book as a consumption of inventory or consumption of my raw material. I will say, for a rough example, giving you understanding. So I will, when in the year which I will book revenue, the proportionate expenses I will book for the same period. That is matching concept. जिस पीरियड में रेवेन्यू बुक करे उसी पीरियड में उसके रिलेटेड का एक्सपेंस बुक करना है. होप यू गॉट दैट. नाउ नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट इज फुल डिस्क्लोजर. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय फुल डिस्क्लोजर? लाइक द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट शुड मेक फुल फेयर एंड एडिक्वेट डिस्क्लोजर टू ऑल एंड ऑफ ऑल इंफॉर्मेशन विच इज important for making financial decisions. Very simple. Full disclosure concept says financial statement should make full, fair and adequate disclosure of all information which is relevant for taking financial decisions. So we are done with the chapter 2. Now tomorrow in next session we will move to chapter number 3 and we'll start with practical problems. Time being, if you have any queries and anything, you can comment it below. And if you need any help from me for studying your 11th, 12th chapter, you can mail me at rahulbajaj41@gmail.com. I am noting it down here again for your reference. Ask your queries. You can comment your queries below. To receive further updates, please subscribe this channel. This will help you to understand basic concepts of accounts. I'm not skipping any chapter. I will be taking all the chapters of 11th standard for your reference. 11th to 12th standard. This is very critical and important points. All those points have been covered. You can write your queries to me at rahulbajaj41@gmail.com. Please, for further update, subscribe my channel. Thank you.